MrExcel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 1363, Insert Hyperlink versus Equal Hyperlink. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen from MrExcel.com, talking about hyperlinks. One of the questions I get when we're talking about hyperlinks is, what's the difference between Insert Hyperlink, the menu feature, versus the Equal Hyperlink function? When should you use one, and when should you use the other? Okay, well, let's just type here, www.MrExcel.com, press enter. You see that a hyperlink is automatically inserted there, and really that's just a shortcut of using the insert hyperlink. All right, so let me select this text, and we'll go to hyperlink, and it says, all right, well, you know, where do you want to go? Well, I want to go to an existing file or web page. Where am I going? Click OK, and you see there's lots of different options here with insert hyperlink. I could create a hyperlink to a place in this document or something like that. Like for example, if you're going to create a little menu system and you wanted to allow people to jump to a specific section of the workbook, we could do that with insert hyperlink. So I want to go to a place in this document, and where do I want to go? I want to go to report 1, and cell A1 is fine. I just want to get them to the sheet. But if I wanted them to go to, like for example, C5000, well, we could do it that way. Click OK. And there's only 5 sections of this report, so it wouldn't take me that long to go through and do the 5 sections. In fact, here, let's just do it. Less than 30 seconds, I guess, once I'm kind of in the groove here. And report 5, click OK. There we go. Now I have a nice little clickable menu to use. And so the insert hyperlink, very nice little system for adding hyperlinks. It's really easy to add navigation. But what happens when you don't just have 5 things to do, but you have hundreds of things to do? Well, that's really where the hyperlink function will work. So I want to create hyperlinks to all of these articles. And for each article, I have the article description, I have the domain where it's running, and notice it doesn't have the HTTP or www or .com, and then the article ID. All right, so here's what we're going to do. We're going to come out here to the right-hand side, equal hyperlink. And first thing it wants to know is the link location. I'm going to build this using something in Excel called concatenation. What a big word. I just call it joining text. The important thing you have to know is the ampersand, shift 7 on a US keyboard, will let you join different pieces of text together. So the first thing to do, in quotes, http://// www dot, close the quotes, ampersand, whatever's over here in the domain, and then another ampersand, in quotes, .com/, and I'll just make up something here, I'll say article ID equals ampersand, that number, ampersand dot ASPX. All right, you're going to have to get the exact URL, but you get the sense here that using these bits and some text in quotes, you can build the complete hyperlink. All right, so we're done now with the link location. I'll type a comma, and then they want to know the friendly name. Well, hey, the friendly name is the description over here in column D, so I just click on D4. Closing parenthesis. I now have a hyperlink that works. Now check this out. One of my favorite tricks, we're going to go to that fill handle, this tiny square dot in the lower right-hand corner. Double click. Bam! That just added hundreds of hyperlinks a lot faster than going through and using the insert hyperlink function, right? Just absolutely amazing, amazing way to go. Now, I really don't need all that stuff over in B, C, and D anymore. So let's take this whole range. I'll start up here in E4, Control Shift down arrow, Control C to copy, and then on home, paste special, and choose values. That gets rid of those formulas, and what's left are just the article titles with very, very nice hyperlinks. Now your call here, whether you want to hide these columns, hiding the columns would let you come back and get to them later, or just delete the columns. Either way, whatever you think. All right, there we go, our list of articles. So I just created hundreds of hyperlinks using the hyperlink function. That, for me, is the value proposition in the hyperlink function. Well, hey, there you have it. The difference between insert hyperlink and the hyperlink function. I want to thank you for stopping by. See you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.